Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with Syncfusion Blazor In-Place Editor. The editor is used for editing a value dynamically within its context, and has built-in support for all the form controls, including TextBox, Dropdown List, and DatePicker. The editor can be rendered in inline and pop-up modes. To explore other features available, refer to the link in the card above. Now, let's add the Syncfusion Blazor Editor to a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2019. In this tutorial, I am going to create a new Blazor app, but before I create one, I will make sure the latest version of the .NET Core SDK is installed in my machine. I should also have Visual Studio Code, Visual Studio 2019, or Visual Studio 2022 installed. With that confirmed, let's start building the app. Let me open Visual Studio 2019 and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose Blazor WebAssembly app and click Next. I name my project Blazor Editor Example and click Next. After that, I click the Create button with the default target framework selected to complete the project creation. The project has been created and ready to use. If you want to know more about Blazor WebAssembly apps and how to add Syncfusion components, click the video link shown in the YouTube card above. Now, let's add the Blazor Editor component. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor In-Place Editor NuGet package into my application. So, I will open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choosing Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I will search for Syncfusion Blazor In-Place Editor in the Browse tab and install it into my project. After the installation is complete, I navigate to the imports.razor file and add the Syncfusion Blazor In-Place Editor namespace to start using the editor in any of the components available under the Pages folder. Next, I open the program file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. I register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling the method addSyncfusionBlazor within this main method. Here, I set the ignore script isolation option to true to load the script reference externally. I should also register a valid license key in my application, so let me register a trial license key using the register license method. I then need to define the CSS for the Blazor In-Place Editor. I navigate to the index.html file to reference the CSS file from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Then, I will add the script reference here, as I have enabled ignore script isolation option for better loading performance of the application. Now, everything is configured, let me add the Blazor In-Place Editor component. I need to open the index.razor component, where I will remove the default code by including a table and a few TD elements. I have planned to design the form to modify the basic information of a person. So, within this TD element, I add the Blazor In-Place Editor code with the TValue property. First, I am going to add the name field in the form. So, let me set field title as name. Then, I need to add TextBox component to display the input value. To use TextBox component, I need to import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor inputs and define TextBox component within the editor component tag. Next, I will add the placeholder property with the value enter your name, which will be displayed in the TextBox component as its description. As I said before, I am going to modify the basic information of a person, so let me add the heading as modify the details. Here, I did not set the editor input type because, by default, it will be text. Now, I will run this example. Look at the output page, it displays a text box, and you can add the text. Suppose, I want to show default input value in the text box. Then, I will define a string variable, text value, and assign an appropriate value to it. Now, I will assign this variable to the bind value property of the in-place editor and text box component to specify the value for input when the input value is empty. And here, you can see the defined input value initially. Next, I will show you how to add the date picker component to set and modify the date of birth of Andrew. To use DatePicker component, first, I need to install the Blazor Calendars package. As I have already installed the Syncfusion Blazor Calendar package in my project, I am skipping this step here. Next, I need to import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor Calendars within this index.razor page. Here, I add one more table row tag and define the Blazor in-place editor code with the properties t-value and type as date-time. Then, to add the date-picker component, let me add the Blazor date-picker component with the t-value and placeholder properties. Next, I will define a date-time variable, date-time-value, and assign an appropriate date to it. Now, I will assign this variable to the bind value property of the in-place editor and date picker component to specify the value for input when the input value is empty. See the output page now. The in-place editor component shows the date picker within it. If I want to change the current date, I can either type in the date value or choose from the pop-up. Next, to show the gender of Andrew, let me display the options using the drop-down list component. To use drop-down list component, first, I need to import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor dropdowns within this index.razor page. Here, I add one more table row tag and define the in-place editor component with the properties t-value and type as a drop-down list. Then, to list the options, let me add the Blazor drop-down list component. As I said before, I have planned to display the gender in the list. So, within this code block, I will define a model class, data model, with two fields, name and ID. Then, I will create a list drop-down data of type data model and assign an array of objects. Next, I will define the t-item and t-value properties with appropriate values to specify the data source type and drop-down list value field type, respectively. Now, I need to assign this list drop-down data to the data source property. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the field property of the drop-down list component. So here, I will define a drop-down list field settings tag and map the field name to the text property. Along with this, I will show the default value in the drop-down list. Therefore, let me define a string variable and set its value to male. I will assign this variable to the bind value property of the in-place editor and drop-down list components when original input value is empty. Also, I have defined custom width using width property. Look at the output page now. The drop-down list is displayed with the default value male, and you can also change the options in the list. By default, the inline mode will be rendered when opening an editor. But you can also change the mode to pop-up by setting this mode property. To do that, I define a variable editor mode and set its value to pop-up. Now, I am going to render pop-up mode for in-place editor with TextBox component, so let me assign this variable to the mode property. Now, you can see that the pop-up is displayed when editing the input values. Notice here, by default, the in-place editor input element is highlighted with a dotted underline to show an interactive UI. If I want to remove the dotted line, then I need to define a dictionary variable named HTML attributes and set the data underline attribute to false for the editor root element. I will assign this dictionary variable to the attributes property of the in-place editor component. And here, you can see that, in the gender field, the dotted line is removed. By default, the editor will be opened on single click, double click, or clicking edit icon actions. If I want to edit the input value only through the edit icon action, then I may need to use the editable on property. I plan to edit the drop-down list input value only through the edit icon, so I define the variable set editable type and assign the value edit icon click. Now, I assign this variable to the editable on property of the editor component with the type drop-down list. Looking at the output page now, you can edit the input value of the drop-down list only by clicking the edit icon in the drop-down list. Let me recap what we have covered in this video. We saw how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2019 and add a Syncfusion Blazor In-Place Editor component to it. Also, we discussed how to integrate the components like TextBox, DatePicker, and Dropdown List. We also saw how to remove a highlighted dotted line in the editor. Finally, we saw how to change the mode and event action of the editor. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.